good evening, and thank you for hosting us. I'm just going to tell you a little bit about my parents' background associated with the Holocaust, and then I want to focus a little bit more on their lives after the Holocaust. Both my parents were also Holocaust survivors. My mom was in hiding. First, she was hidden by a neighbor who had a Christian child. And so the neighbor hid my mother as another child. But then some other neighbors came and said, "We know that you are harboring a Jew in your home, and she's got to go." So my mother joined her mother in the forest with a cousin, and they lived underground for more than 2 years before liberation. And she and my mother were in a displaced persons camp. And then I'll link it to how they met my father. My dad, Henry, and I believe you'll see a little bit of his clip. He had two brothers, two parents, and unfortunately, the Nazis told my father's mother and two brothers to go to the right, and they went to the gas chambers. And my dad and his father were sent to a labor camp. And one night, this is going to be associated with the clip that you're going to see at some point this evening. A guard hit my father's father repeatedly, and he knew he was so badly hurt that he was not going to survive through the night. He made my father promise to live and to tell the story and to not let people forget that this can happen to humans, that, you know, one human can perpetrate this type of terror onto another. And so my father was liberated by the Americans, and he later in life met his liberator at a function that he was at. Someone called out, "If you were at, you know, this particular labor camp, please raise your hand." And my mother heard that, and she said, "Henry, you were there." And she met this liberator at this function. And this liberator also lived in Massachusetts, where my parents lived. And there was an incredible, overwhelming, emotional scene. My dad just wouldn't stop hugging this amazing man, and it was quite a reunion. But I wanted to get to that my parents met at displaced persons camp, and they were married in Boston, and they went on to have a really meaningful and thoughtful life, and that despite immense trauma, they were still resilient enough. They had the strength, the survivor strength, to impart really meaningful lessons to us kids. And, you know, to say, "Hey, look, we made it. We're still here despite the Nazis' best efforts." And I think a lot of lessons can be learned from that and from all of the voices of the survivors that were part of this witness testimony. So like everyone else, I too am forever grateful to Harvey for having the courage and strength to make this really important documentary. Thank you.
and my father. And kept on saying to me, remember, remember my son. You must live. You must survive. You must survive. And I'll be with you. I'll be with you. You're gonna find your brothers. You're gonna find your mothers. I swore after my father's death, no matter what, I must survive and to take revenge. I must. And I did everything possible to survive. And I survived, I did. And I walked with my head up and I thought, now I am going to kill. I'm going to kill these Nazi schweins. These are not human beings, this is not civilized people. These are murderers, Nazi murderers. But I couldn't do it. I couldn't kill anybody. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't harm anybody.